Good morning, January 31st. For love's sake. Without your consent, I wanted to do nothing, that your good deed might not be by compulsion, as it were, but voluntary. Philemon chapter 1, verse 14. In Roman times, a wealthy man named Philemon lived in the Colossae region of Asia Minor. One day, his slave Onesimus ran away after stealing some money. The fugitive trekked to Rome, where he met the Apostle Paul and was converted to Christ. Paul sent him home with one of the shortest and most personal letters in our Bible, the Epistle to Philemon. In it, the Apostle exhorts Philemon to consider Onesimus no longer as a slave, but more than a slave, a beloved brother. Verse 16. Paul hints he would like to have Onesimus helping him in his ministry, but he stops short of using his authority to order Philemon to comply. Though I might be very bold in Christ to command you, yet, for love's sake, I rather appeal to you. Verses 8 and 9. The Lord longs for us to obey because we want to, not because we have to. Some religions codify what must be done to others, but true charity comes from the heart. Let's serve God faithfully because we long to please Him each day. We must constantly examine our own lives to ensure that proper actions are produced by proper motives. James A. Borland. Good evening. The second coming of Christ. The end of all things is near. Therefore, be clear-minded and self-controlled so that you can pray. 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 7. For centuries, people have been trying to determine the exact date on which the world will end, even though Jesus expressly told us that it is not for us to know the time. The predictions just seem to continue. The actual date is of little importance if you are equipped and ready to meet Christ. The most important aspect of the second coming is not when it will take place, but whether you will be prepared to meet your Lord and to give account for your life and deeds. People are diligent about earthly matters. They make provision for their retirement. When a storm looms, they close the doors and windows. Farmers protect their livestock from the cold of winter. We insure ourselves against possible loss in the event of theft, loss, and accidents. How much more important is it, then, to prepare yourself spiritually so that you can joyfully anticipate the second coming of Christ? Discipline yourself to spend time in prayer and meditation in the presence of the Lord. Surrender yourself to the leading of the Holy Spirit so that you will be ready whenever He comes.